شكرا يا ربي شكرا هديت قلبي شكرا نورت دربي شكرا شكرا يا ربي
شكرا يا ربي شكرا.
Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that when Ramadan approaches, the 8 doors of Jannah are open, the 7 doors of hellfire are closed, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bestowed, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is released, and the shayateen, the devils, are locked up.
Why is it that Allah has kept every year there is a month that comes and it keeps returning? It's a beautiful month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. Although we are not supposed to be eating in the month of Ramadan, we have lots of food stored in our fridges in the month of Ramadan. Although we are not supposed to be eating in the month of Ramadan, the food that we do have in the evenings tastes much better than the same food when it is eaten, or if it is eaten, before or after the month of Ramadan. You and I know this. The blessings of that month begin the moment the moon is sighted or the moment the month is announced. Automatically you feel the blessings of this beautiful month. But none of us has a guarantee that we are going to witness the month, we are going to see this month. Not a single person has a guarantee that he or she will actually see the month of Ramadan. And so many of us, we have witnessed previously months of Ramadan and our lives have not changed. Maybe in Ramadan we became holy, we became pious, we became noble. We read our salah in Ramadan, and once we saw the moon for Eid, that day Salatul Fajr was not read. Am I right? But it's a fact. Then when Ramadan goes, sometimes we put hijab, month of Ramadan, the minute Ramadan goes, hijab is out. If we want to benefit from the beautiful month of Ramadan that is about to come, let us understand, it is the month of fasting, the month of discipline, the month of taqwa, the month of the Quran, the month of developing a link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the month of repentance, the month of making resolutions so that we can lead the rest of the 11 months of the year leading up to the next Ramadan in a way that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Shaitan has convinced us, my brothers and sisters, that this is the month of activities, whereas in reality, this is the month of ibadah, this is the month of worship. This is the month that your soul and your heart has been crying for all year round. This is the month, my brothers and sisters, I take an oath by Allah, if you give this month its due rights, if you give this month its haqq, if you work hard in this month, wallahi, you will go from zero to hero. I promise you. Wallahi, if you give this month its rights, you will reach the stage of awliya. I promise. This is the month, my brothers, where the doors of Jannah are open and the gates of hellfire are closed. It's the month of mercy. It's the month of forgiveness. So my brothers and sisters, I do not want you to waste this month. You know, because we get so caught up with group activities going and coming, we tend to miss out. You know, my brothers, Sahaba, while they took part in every congregational activity, there was also that personal link between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So just like how you come here for the beautiful Salat al-Tarawih in Jama'ah, there should be a good half an hour between you and Allah at home personally. There has to be that connection. And this month, my brothers, I'm telling you, Allah gives. This is the month, my brothers, where every night Allah Azza wa Jal, every night in this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks down upon this ummah and He handpicks the ones that He wants and He says, you will be saved from hellfire. Hellfire has been made haram on you.
Honor Ramadan the way it should be honored. Those who don't remember Allah, not in Ramadan and not even outside of Ramadan, wal-iyadu billah. Individuals who are heedless of their obligations towards the one who created them, towards the one who gave them good health, who gave them wealth, who differentiated them from animals by giving them aql, by giving them the faculty of intellect, the one who directed them to the dearest of treasures, the deen of Islam and other bounties. Yet they don't pray, and they have the audacity not to fast. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. And do not be like those who forgot about Allah, so He made them forget about themselves. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, while I was sleeping, two men came to me and they took me by the arms and they brought me to a rugged mountain and they said, climb up. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am unable to climb up. So they helped him up, and when he got to the top of the mountain, he said, I heard loud voices. I said, what are these voices? He was told that this is the howling of the people of the hellfire. Then I was taken and I saw people hanging from their hamstrings with their jawbones ripped open and blood gushing out of their mouths. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, who are these? And he was informed that these are people who broke their fast before the time was due. And so, if this is the punishment for those who fasted, yet broke their fast before the correct time.
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. There's no doubt that we have entered the month of Sha'ban. And the word Sha'ban came from the Arabic word Shu'ba. And Shu'ba literally means a branch, because goodness branches out from it. And that's why the month of Ramadan comes immediately after Sha'ban. So the question remains, how do we prepare for this noble and blessed month? There's no doubt that planning for Ramadan begins before Ramadan, as the famous quote goes, that failing to plan is planning to fail. And as Shaykh Abu Bakr al-Balkhi, he had a beautiful saying in regards to planning for Ramadan. He said, شهر رجب شهر الزرع وشهر شعبان شهر سقي الزرع وشهر رمضان شهر حصاد الزرع. He said, شهر رجب, which is 2 months prior to Ramadan, is the month of planting. And the month of شعبان is the month of irrigating and watering what you've planted. And the month of Ramadan is the month of harvesting and reaping what you've sowed prior. So he's teaching us that planning for Ramadan actually begins 2 months prior to Ramadan. Now the question remains, what about those who haven't planned anything before Ramadan, let alone 2 months prior? Well, the scholar said there is a way out, don't lose hope. For the first 10 nights of Ramadan are your planting, and the next 10 nights are your watering, and the last 10 nights of Ramadan you're harvesting and reaping what you've planted. In other words, make every single day and every single night count in this blessed month of Ramadan. As for some practical tips and practical pointers on how to prepare for Ramadan, among the things we can do starting from tonight is to stand up for Qiyamul Layl, even if it's something small. For the best of deeds, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, adwamuha wa in falla. Those deeds which are adwam, yani they are consistent from da'iman, they are consistent even if they are qaleela, even if they are small. So let's, inshallah ta'ala, from tonight, pray 2 rak'at tahajjud, just 2, and then cap it off with 1 witr. That is it. If we can just do that and be consistent, then inshallah ta'ala, when we get to Ramadan, we have something up our sleeves. You can imagine, for example, a person who hasn't done any training all year, and when they get to the grand final, They put all of their efforts and exhaust everything in the opening 10 minutes. Of course, they'll be burnt out. They won't survive the rest of the game. Well, that's the parable for many Muslims in Ramadan. They haven't done anything all year, and then when they get to Ramadan, they exhaust all of their efforts in the opening 10 nights of Ramadan, thus they are burnt out. You don't see them throughout this noble month, and they may show up again for the 27th, hoping to catch Laylatul Qadr, and then they go back to sleep again, and then they wake up again on Eid, and they go back to sleep, and you don't see them again until next Ramadan. Allahu musta'an. Now, this is not the way of the believer, but rather, think of Ramadan as a 300 meter dash. Think of it like a race, where you start off slowly, gradually increase speed, pace yourself so you don't collapse before the finish line. That's how Ramadan is. Let's prepare starting from tonight. And also, when we get to Ramadan, as we said, let's not exhaust our efforts, but rather let's increase and improve slowly but surely. And that's the idea of Laylatul Qadr. The opening ayah of Laylatul Qadr, Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr, Allah Azza wa Jalla is teaching us that the best of books was sent down to the best of men, via the best of angels, on the best of nights, to the best of places, to the best of nations, and the best of generations. This surah is teaching us to be the best of the best. Thus, when we try to attain Laylatul Qadr, we should be at the best and peak of our worship. In other words, the last 10 nights, teaching us not to burn ourselves out in the opening night of Ramadan. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to deliver us to this blessed month and to enable us to prepare for Ramadan, a great and solid preparation. Jazakumullahu khairan for your attentive listening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
هديت قلبي شكرا.